like Ambridge.
Why don't you like Ambridge?
Because they just keep ruining other people's lives.
And what was your some of your symptoms that you had after the oil spill?
I had 3 seizures at the other house and 2 seizures where I live now.
What was the fumes like?
They were very strong. They give you like a funny taste in your throat. It makes your throat kind of sore if you're breathing it in a lot.
Did you get sick from it?
Yes, I got migraines. I had a seizure for the first time in my life.
You had a seizure after the oil spill, the first time in your life?
Yes.
And then my son actually had an episode where he looked like he was having seizures, passing out. I even took him to the ER, and they just counted it as dehydration.
Well, it's from the oil spill. It's from the chemicals.
In the hallway, push the right button to the left. It's okay, babe. I got you. It's okay. It's almost over. 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 Can you lift this chair? Slide. Shut your chair up.
Don't get pulled.
It hurts, I know, baby.
I know, honey.
Mama.
It's okay, it's okay.
Help me, Mom.
It's okay.
They're all right.
Who am I?
Michelle. Okay. That hurt.
I know it hurt. Hold on, baby. I'm
butchering you. Oh, gosh.
It's okay. Who am I?
Michelle. Hello.
Who's president?
Clinton.
Okay. It's okay. He's over. Any chest pain?
No.
Okay. Just relax for a minute.
Okay.
My daughter goes the same thing, so I know.
Who has the same thing?
My daughter.
Your daughter has seizures too?
Yeah. Okay, it's cold. Okay. Just relax.
I'm trying.
Thanks.
I'm sorry for videotaping, but people got to see this.
No, it's fine, John. Oh, gosh.
This is why we have to stop Ambridge and these oil companies from doing this. They're having seizures, and they're getting sick from this tar sand oil. Please help us.
The muscles spasms? Your legs or your arms?
Arms.
Okay.
Here, give me an ice cube.
Don't get it.
No, I'm not, honey.
So what, you put ice around on his body?
Cool him off.
Miscarriages or problems with the child, delayed growth, stunted growth, mental problems as well. elders. Our body is like a rain barrel, and throughout your whole life, that rain barrel fills up, drip, 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 with toxic chemicals. And your body's doing the best it can to try to break these things down and get them out. But as an elder or as an older person, you could just get overwhelmed. You know, your body can just get overwhelmed. It's fighting this, it's fighting that. It's maybe fighting some other chronic illnesses or health problems you have. And suddenly here comes an oil spill on top of everything else. And the spill can act as a triggering event where it can actually make other health problems worse. So, elders. African Americans, I'm really sorry to say, looking around the community here, because African Americans are prone to blood disorders anyway, sickle cell anemia, and the oil creates blood disorders or can make them worse. And finally, anybody with already existing health problems, because your system is already compromised and weakened. So this is like a no-kidding situation here. In the Gulf, we had hands across the sand. The symptoms across the Gulf. Stuffy nose, bad headache, sore throat, even blisters in the throat. Sorry. Hoarseness, dizziness, nausea, ear and nose bleeds. People would wake up in the morning with their pillow just soaked. Kids, adults. Skin rashes, I have pictures of some of that. Peeling hands and soles of feet from walking in the sand. Blood in the urine, blood in the vomit, blood in the stool.
Their real strength is in themselves. It's not waiting for the government to help you or waiting for Enbridge to help you. It's really about how can we organize as a community what it is that we want rather than hearing what Enbridge will do for us or not do, what the government can or can't do, as in, we really can't help you with any of the health stuff. No, what is it that people want and how are we going to get what we want as a community, not as individuals, but by grouping together and using leverage points, meet with the media, with the politicians, and with our own selves, with our own community and social networking.